great wars. For this reason, you shall not build a house for my name, because you have shed much blood on the earth in my sight. A son shall be born to you, who shall be a man of rest or peace, and he shall build a house for my name. You see, God accepted the fact that, and he honored the fact that David wanted to do more for him. But because of circumstances and David's past, he tells David that you are not the man for this job. A lot of times God will tell us no. That we are not the man or the woman for this job. You know, a lot of times we think we can do everything. You know, we think every job is for us. You know, you go to those job interviews and you say, well, I'm a quick learner. You know, I could adapt. You know, but there are certain jobs that you have no place, you know, taking a risk at. And those of you who don't know, I go to the dentist quite a bit. And the last time I went in, just about a year ago, I thought I was over my fears of the dentist. But the dentist saw right through me. And even someone who is qualified, I was not really trusting that much to do the work on my mouth. So imagine someone who just says, well, I could learn, I could do this, you know, just step into the office. Right. You know, I'm definitely not sitting on that seat. Right. You see, some jobs we can't take risks at doing. And this was one of them. Because David had shed much blood. He was a man of war. But God knew that when he built his temple, he needed someone of peace. Someone who would not bring the enemies around that temple to destroy it. And that's what David would have done. But Solomon, we are told, was a man of peace. But when God tells you no, what do you do? Let's look at what David did. Because God told him no. But David was determined to do something for God. Let's turn to 1 Chronicles chapter 22. Let's go back there. And let's read from verse 1. The Bible says, then David said, this is the house of the Lord God. And this is the altar of burnt offering for Israel. So David gave orders to gather the foreigners who were in the land of Israel. He set stone cutters to hew out stones to build the house of God. David prepared large quantities of iron to make the nails for the doors of the gates and for the clamps, and more bronze that could be weighed. Now this is amazing. Because God told this man no, but he is still doing all this work. So that when Solomon comes in, all he has to do is build a house. Yes, sir. And timbers of cedar logs beyond number. For the Sidonians and Tyrians, these were the same people who built David's palace. And David said, my son Solomon is young and inexperienced. And the house that is to be built for the Lord shall be exceedingly magnificent, famous, and glorious throughout all the lands. Now you see, David noticed that he would need to help in some way. You know, we are strong in certain categories, but we have our weaknesses. David realized, well, Solomon was chosen to build his house, but he may not know where to find the resources to build it. And so he decided, I will do it for him. Is that our attitude when God tells us no? Or are we like the child on the playground? Or the child who brings his basketball to the court? He doesn't get picked for the game and decides, well, if I can't play, I take my ball and I go home. We know what I'm talking about, right? You know, there are some times when we go in and when we try to lead or put our input, and we're given another job that we decide, well, you know, if I can't do this job that I came for, I'm not going to have anything to do with it. But that's not what God wants from us. Because look at what David did. God told him, well, no, you're not the builder of this house. But God didn't stop him from collecting the resources.
Yes, sir.
See, David had the zeal for God that even though God told him no, he would not stop working for that house that he wanted to build. Notice that he didn't just give God anything. He gave God the best of everything in the land. When God tells us no, let's not give him half of what we could do. Let's put our all into it. Let's give him everything that we have. Because he deserves our best. And so the house is built. But there are two great promises in this passage. 2 Samuel chapter 7, if you go back there with me. 2 Samuel chapter 7, verses 12 through 13. It says, when your days are complete, and you lie down with your fathers, this is God talking to David. He says, I will raise up your descendant after you, which is Solomon, who will come forth from you, and I will establish his kingdom. He shall build a house for my name, and I will establish the throne of his kingdom forever. And I will be a father to him, and he will be a son to me. Now there are some great promises. First, that God would have Solomon build the temple. And the second one is even more important. That he would set up a dynasty of kings. And that kingdom, that throne would reign forever. This is very important because we see in Luke chapter 1, verse 31. The Bible says, and behold, you will conceive, this is the angel of God talking to Mary, you will conceive in your womb bear a son, and you shall call him Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David. And he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. And his kingdom, the Bible says, will have no end. Isn't God amazing?
Yes.
But this is us today. The kingdom of God.
Yes.
What God was building through David. And we're blessed to be here this morning. And to be called children of God. To be called the temple of God. To be vessels of God.
Yes.
You know, when God put his spirit in us, to dwell with our spirit. But one day we know that we'll get this temple. Because we are now like, when David made the statement, that tent that they were moving around with, that God dwelt in, we are that temporary tent. But we long for that eternal body, that eternal temple, that eternal vessel, one that cannot be shaken, one that is not torn down, one that does not decay, but one that cannot be destroyed, one that will last forever. God is amazing. And so we are here in this temple. And though it may be temporary, I challenge you that we do the best, that we give God what he deserves while we are in this temple.
Yes.
You know, Paul says it best.